we like to talk about lives changed. So Dyke, if you'll come on in. And this is really cool story right here. Dyke and I have met in the past few weeks. And this is after church, walking around in the auditorium. And Dyke says, I need to talk to you. And so we spent probably 20, 30 minutes into the second service and going through the gospel and just really getting a reassurance of his faith in Jesus Christ, that he wants to follow him and repent and be, changed in his life. So he knew his salvation had come, but he wasn't following Jesus like he should. And so he goes, I want to raise my flag. I want people to know that I am following Jesus Christ. He is my King and my Savior. So we are excited about that today, aren't we, folks? So, and I love Dyke's excitement. Y'all stand on up. This is exciting today. Listen, I want you to hear this. Dyke, how old are you?
I'm 65.
He's 65, y'all. Hey, that means it doesn't matter what age you are. If you're a young person, I spoke to 200 of our kids on Friday, shared the gospel. I hope they get baptized soon. But if you're in your 60s, your 70s, your 80s, it doesn't matter what age. You want to be obedient to Jesus Christ, right? And so that's what's happening today. So, Dyke, do you believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins and rose from the grave?
I do.
And you want to follow him today in believer's baptism?
I do.
You have repented of your sins. You're going to follow him today. Dyke, upon your profession of faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, I now baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. If you'll step up here. Buried in his likeness. Raised to walk in Jesus.